Our government is in knots over ways to lower the federal budget deficit. Well, what if we told you we found a pot of money, over $60 billion a year, that could be used to help out? That bundle is tax money not coming into the IRS from American corporations. One major way they avoid paying the tax man is by parking their profits overseas. They'll tell you they're forced to do that because the 35% corporate tax rate is high in relation to other countries. And indeed, it seems the tax code actually encourages companies to move businesses out of the country. Companies searching out tax havens is nothing new. In the 80s and 90s, there was an exodus to Bermuda and the Cayman Islands, where there are no taxes at all. When President Obama threatened to clamp down on tax dodging, many companies decided to leave the Caribbean. But instead of coming back home, they went to safer havens like Switzerland. Several of these companies came to this tiny dot on the Swiss map called Zug, a small, quaint, medieval town.
I don't think anybody's ever heard of Zug in the United States.
Hans Marti, who heads Zug's economic development office, showed off the nearby snow-covered mountains. But Zug's main selling point isn't a view of the Alps.
How low are the taxes here?
It's something between 15 and 16%.
And in the United States, it's 35%.
I know. It's half, half price.
And do you have the lowest tax rate in Switzerland?
Most probably, yes.
Most probably, yes. So you're kind of a tax haven within a tax haven.
Maybe, yes.
Yeah.
The population of the town of Zug is 26,000. The number of companies in the area, 30,000 and growing at an average rate of 800 a year, but many are no more than mailboxes. Texas Democratic Congressman Lloyd Doggett questions whether the recent moves of several companies are legit.
A good example is one of my Texas companies that's been in the news lately, Transocean.
Transocean owned the drilling rig involved in the giant BP oil spill. They moved to Zug 2 years ago.
I'm not sure they even moved that much. They have about 1,300 employees still in the Houston area. Mm-hmm. They have 12 or 13 in Switzerland.
And yet they claim they're headquartered over there.
They claim they're Swiss. And they claim they're Swiss for tax purposes. And by doing that, by renouncing their American citizenship, they've saved about $2 billion in taxes.
So here we are in Zug.
We went to find their operations here.
And we came to see your international headquarters.
The moment my boss is not here, so...
She said her boss wasn't there, and we should call someone halfway around the world.
In Houston?
Yeah.
Not here?
No.
But this is the headquarters.
I know.
And is the CEO here?
No.
I mean, normally here?
No.
Okay. All right.
Another Texas company that moved here is Weatherford, a $10 billion oil field services firm. It still has 2,800 workers in Houston. But according to official documents, they are incorporated in Zug in this small building. But there was no Weatherford on the sign outside.
Finally found it listed in this thing, Weatherford International. Here's the mailbox. But we don't know even where to go. There's no listing for the international headquarters of Weatherford.
So we started knocking on doors.
Hi.
Grüezi.
We're looking for Weatherford. Are they in this building?
Yes.
Here?
Just a moment, please. I have to check it.
Okay. All right.
I was shown to a conference room. They said Weatherford rents for board meetings. But Weatherford's Houston office told us they never go there. So are these big companies pulling a fast one? Well, apparently not. Under both Zug and U.S. tax laws, it's perfectly legal to get the low tax rate even without a real presence here. But Congressman Doggett wants to change that.
You have a proposed legislation that a company will be taxed not based on where they file some pieces of paper, but where their decision makers, their management, actually resides and makes decisions.
Let them pay the same way that other Houston-based companies pay. And so if they have their management and control there, they ought to be paying here in the United States. I think it's fair.
We found that faced with the mere threat of Doggett's legislation, Transocean and Weatherford both recently packed up their top brass and shipped them to Geneva.
We were told Transocean's top 10 executives live around here in the Geneva area and work on the top two floors of this building. Everyone from the CEO to the chief financial officer to the vice president of taxes.
They wouldn't talk to us on camera, and neither would Weatherford. They also moved their CEO and CFO to Geneva. And so now we're beginning to see a jobs exodus from the U.S. of top management.
We can't write a law that their lawyers can't get around. That's the whole problem here.
You're in Congress. Why did Congress write these laws that allows this to happen?
There's been a lot of arm twisting, a lot of effective lobbying here, and some really smart tax lawyers figuring out how to game the system with one shenanigan after another.
But are they shenanigans or is it the law?
I think it was a shenanigan when some of these companies felt so strongly about America that they renounced their American citizenship and began saluting a foreign flag. They exploited a provision in our tax laws and moved offshore.
Congress tried to put a stop to that with a law passed in 2004 mandating that any company that wanted to move offshore would still have to pay the 35%. But because of loopholes in the tax code, companies can substantially lower their taxes by moving chunks of their businesses to their foreign subsidiaries. I think when people hear that all these companies are moving overseas because of taxes, they think that doesn't smell right.
Yeah, the question is, does a company have a moral obligation to pay its fair share?
Swiss tax attorney Thierry Boitel.
I think many companies in the U.S. would like to keep the jobs in the U.S. if they could. But they also need to keep the shareholders happy. And they are in the U.S. in a corporate tax nightmare because it's the highest tax rate in the world.
With Japan slated to lower its rate in April, the U.S. will soon have the highest corporate tax rate in the developed world.
We are dealing with a tax system that is a dinosaur.
One CEO who would talk to us is John Chambers, head of Cisco, the giant high-tech company headquartered in San Jose. He says our tax rate is insane. It's forcing companies into these maneuvers, especially when many other industrialized countries, including Canada, are busy lowering their tax rates in order to lure our companies and our jobs away.
Every other government in the world have realized that the U.S. has it wrong. They're saying, I'm going to have lower taxes, period. That's what you see across all of Western Europe. That's what you see in Asia and the developed countries.
Are you judged as a CEO on things like this, on taxes?
Absolutely.
He's been expanding Cisco overseas because of growing demand abroad, but also to lower the company's taxes. Their average rate over the last 3 years, just 20%. Economist Martin Sullivan says it's standard operating procedure for companies like Cisco.
U.S. multinationals are shifting their research facilities, shifting their manufacturing facilities, and shifting some regional headquarters into Switzerland and into Ireland. And those are massive numbers of jobs.
He says Ireland taxes corporations at just a third of the U.S. rate. So no wonder the outskirts of Dublin look like Silicon Valley. These companies are all but obliged to go abroad.
Well, if you have a 35% rate in the United States and, for example, a 12.5% rate in Ireland, there's an incentive to move your factory to Ireland.
600 American companies are in Ireland, mm-hmm. and they employ 100,000 people.
That's right.
Those are jobs that aren't here.
Mm-hmm.
And they moved to Ireland because of taxes.
Mm-hmm. The U.S. Treasury, in effect, is subsidizing investment in Ireland.
Why isn't everybody in Ireland?
Well, almost everybody is in Ireland. All the pharmaceutical companies, all the high-tech companies. You're stupid if you're not in Ireland.
We noticed that you have an awful lot of companies in Ireland.
Yes, we do.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 companies in Ireland.
Mm-hmm. We do what makes sense to the shareholders. We go where there are incentives in countries that say, we want you here, we're going to give you tax advantages, we want you to add jobs here, etc. We can no longer in America say, this is how we do it, therefore you must do it. We've got to change and we're going to get left behind.
An increasingly popular way, particularly pharmaceutical and high-tech companies like Google avoid paying the 35%, is to shift their patents, computer code, pill formulas, even logos from their U.S. bases to their outposts in low-tax countries.
100 years ago, if a company wanted to relocate, you know, you'd have to pick up a factory, machinery, move everything. Yeah. Today, a company can move predominantly all of its assets just on paper.
You can push a button and move your algorithms in our own.
Or Coca-Cola could take the recipe out of the vault and put it in a Swiss vault.
Yeah, and then it's Swiss.
Yeah.
When a formula or a computer code is registered abroad, say in Zug, a U.S. company is allowed to claim that a lot of its taxable profits are there, even if most of its sales are in the U.S.
The need for tax reform is greater than ever.
Economist Sullivan told Congress these patents and profit transfers are accounting tricks that allowed companies to chip away at the 35% and save tens of billions of dollars. He says that from 2007 to 2009, these maneuvers helped lower Pfizer's average tax rate to 17%, Merck to 12.5%, and GE just 3.6%.
You know, what's really remarkable as I review the data is the consistency with which you see this phenomenon. The taxes are going down, the profits are shifting offshore at an accelerated rate over the last few years.
So now these companies have profits accumulating overseas in places like Zug.
Oh, look at your clock tower.
If they bring the money home, it's taxed at the full 35%. If they leave it overseas, the IRS can't touch it. In other words, the tax law all but forces companies to keep their money out of the country indefinitely.
We leave the money over there, I create jobs overseas, I acquire companies overseas, I build plants overseas, and I badly want to bring that money back.
How much does your company have overseas that could be brought back?
Almost $40 billion. $40 billion.
Cisco has $40 billion trapped over there somewhere.
Yes.
The total amount of money U.S. companies have trapped overseas is $1.2 trillion. Chambers is advocating for a one-time tax break to allow them to bring that money home at a rate of, say, 5%. He says that would stimulate the economy and create jobs.
What is your downside for money that isn't going to come back anyhow? I'd say your downside is zero.
But the Obama administration opposes this idea. When it was tried in 2005, the Treasury did rake in billions of dollars, though very few jobs were created.
What if tomorrow Congress passed a quickie law and the tax rate was 20%?
Mm-hmm.
Would that solve everything?
I think it is the most important ingredient that we have to think about being competitive.
You lower the rate from 35% to 20%. You lose something like $2 trillion in taxes. We have a horrible deficit crisis, debt crisis. Mm-hmm. That's almost too much money to lose. What's your answer to that?
My answer is very simply. Every other developed country in the world has already done this. I'm not asking you to give me a favor or a handout.
You know what? It sounds it.
All we're asking is give us a level playing field. Get us close.